Welcome to my channel. My name is Dora. On this channel, I share with you simple tips of how to manage, take care of your natural hair. So in today's video, I'm going to show you what I do when I have done shampoo on my hair. So when it comes to hair is managing natural hair, or this type of hair is a combination of technique, knowledge, and this is the only way you will be able to manage your hair without any problem. First and foremost, it's always good to work with your hair in sections. As you can see, I have washed my hair while they were in twists. Okay, so these were my kind of small twists. So the tip that I'm going to give you is work or retwist your hair immediately after deep conditioning your hair or after shampoo. But it's advisable to deep condition after shampoo because shampoo rips away the hair oils that you have, and so it's always good to follow up with a good deep conditioner to restore the moisture back to your hair. So this is what I do. For those of you who want to know how I make my shea butter, my homemade shea butter, there's a link up. Feel free to go and see how I do it. This homemade hair butter is extremely moisturizing and I really enjoy it. So now I want you to watch the technique, the technique that I use. You see, every time you shampoo your hair will definitely tangle. Okay, and how you manage to detangle your hair is the technique that I'm trying to show you right now. So I just need you to watch how I was able to easily remove that tangle that you were seeing, that you see I had before. So the thing about natural hair is try to use your fingertips as much as you can. I know there's a belief that you have to comb through your hair, but personally, I believe that the more you run a comb through your hair, you are not only ripping your hair off, but you are also reducing the density of your hair. And this is the reason why so many people cry that, oh, my hair is becoming sparse on my head. Of course, the comb will do that. So you can see when you finger detangle, you only get rid of the hair that naturally has to be shed off. On a daily basis, at least, normal shedding should be anything from 30 strands to 100 strands of hair, which is normal. So no one should deceive you that, you know, you shouldn't see any single hair getting out of your scalp every time you're trying to do something with your hair. So just watch the technique of what I'm doing. So this is how I have managed to grow my hair. This is how I have managed to keep my hair thick and healthy. So if you're new to this channel, welcome, welcome. Please do not forget to give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and make sure you click on that notification bell so that every time I post a new video, you are the first to know. And my subscribers, you know, I'm always ever grateful for your love. Thank you. Thank you for always coming back to catch up with my videos. And that gives me the motivation to keep sharing with you what I do with my hair. So as you can see, this is what I do with my hair. I take my time. And this brings me to the other issue that you need to be patient. If you're not patient with this process, then you are going to get challenges with maintaining your hair or even retaining length. When you use your finger, naturally the hair that has shed off will slide off, and the best time is when you have just done deep conditioning, because that's when the hair is at its best. It has taken in all the moisture and it is ready to survive for the coming days. depending on how long it is. So this is what I need you to see. When you pull your hair, you can see the length. This, you know, it is normal shaved hair. But if your hair is long and then you see small bits of hair, short hairs, then that simply is a sign that your hair is breaking. So you should be able to see the length of your hair in hair that has come out. That way you know that it is normal shedding. So basically this is what I do, and this is something that can be done. And what I also do is I try to twist my hair loosely all the time. Actually, most of the time I wear loose twists. One, when you keep your hair in loose twists, it is very less, your hair will not tangle so much. You know the temptation of having very small twists, and also you keep it on for a very long time. Our hair loves each other, and they love to intertwine themselves. So when you loosely twist, definitely it will not. And again, that's another tip that you just show me doing. Make sure you give the ends of your hair enough pattern. So in this form, it's very easy for me to detangle my hair. It's very easy for me to keep my hair from tangles. And for the next wash day or the time I decide to wash my hair, I find it very easy to work with my hair. And then as you can see, I'm just going to loosely twist it back, and then I leave it to air dry. I know that most of you prefer to use heat, you prefer to use hair dryers, but also be very careful. So the more heat you use on your hair, the more it sucks out the moisture. And regular use of this definitely is not healthy. So you can see when you do this, it's very easy. The shed hairs will just come out smoothly without any resistance. So basically this is it. And then of course the ends of your hair give you some love. And as you can see, this is all the hair that I have shed. And this is normal shedding, it's not abnormal shedding. So, guys, I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. Give me a thumbs up. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.